Ready, start. Sir, my first question is whether there is any particular strategy at all which our government is applying to control the price rise. Because we had the 3 years of the Janta rule when there was no strategy at all. Even the plan was called the rolling plan. That is why I am asking, what is the strategy? It is not my intention to theorize rise here or to sound scholastic, because scholastic debates are not meant for parliament, but common sense is. I firmly believe that no theory can be viable unless it can be understood by common sense. In a nutshell, I look at the economic strategy of our government in the 1980s as radically different from the past. There was hardly any difference in the styles and approaches of the previous two decades. The approach then was of the demand management without caring from the supply side. The Keynesian scholars who dominated the planning process in those days presumed that the role of the government in the economy was only confined to maintaining the suitable levels of aggregate demand. And since the government alone could print money, the chief instrument of demand, it was also presumed that fiscal measures alone could control the entire economy. Thus, demand held the key to all government policies, and slowly the supply side got a back seat. So, when there was a glut of goods in the market, it was through that the crisis could have be warded off by discouraging savings and encouraging spending, that is, through a fiscal remedy. Similarly, in a condition of scarcity, the first thing that the government would do was to tax the goods heavily, thus trying to lower consumption by artificial means. The proof of all this is there in the chain of licensing procedures, the maze of statutes and laws binding business activities, all formulated during the 1970s and the 1980s. One statement, the guiding principle then was demand creates supply. I am happy that our government has revised this stand. Instead of being obsessed with the demand side, for the first time we have launched ourselves on a program to tackle the supply side. We now want to say that if the prices refuse to come down, if the inflation rate leapfrogs, the government cannot solve the problem by taxing the goods, by passing laws that will only discourage consumption. The new strategy of our government is to remove constraints on supply, on the artificial barriers between the producer and the consumer, and give the manufacturing sector a chance to function without any hindrance. The supply side economics has an emphasis on growth and not on distribution. Actually, supply side economics is in direct contrast to the demand side economics, which we have been following earlier. Though I am in full agreement with this theoretical shift, which is now being totally reversed by the theory that supply creates demand, I would have been happier if all-round measures were taken to improve supplies. One very important part in supply side management is the infrastructure. The toning up of the infrastructure has to be done with greater effort and with more speed. There is no doubt that the infrastructure has improved. During this quarter, power generation increased by 17% over the corresponding period last year, coal production by about 8% and goods movement by railways by about 16%. Down the line, there has also been a rise in the production of saleable steel by about 26%, cement by about 19%, crude petroleum by about 64%, petroleum products by 21%, and fertilizer by 65%. However, despite all these improvements, I still think that our infrastructure is very much infra. Even though our coal production has registered such a sharp increase, there has been chronic shortages for superior grade coal used in industry. The movement of goods on the railways has increased, but one still has to ponder how much of it is due to higher prices for trucking and how much of it is genuine. We have also to see to what extent the increase in our power generation is because of the good monsoon, because of which the generation of hydel power has to be commensurate with the supply side management which we are attempting. In fact, our attempts have to be doubled towards infrastructure within the next couple of months. One crucial area of concern for all of us should be the money supply situation. While I commend the efforts made by the government for decreasing the money supply situation in the country, I still feel that the recent impounding of currency in our monetary systems is not adequate enough. The cash reserve ratio and the statutory liquidity ratio have been increased. This may curtail the liquidity of the banks to the trading sector. Stop.